Dito na yung mga walang pagkain.
Oh, walang pagkain.
Glasang tubig eh.
Hi.
Andito na kami sa Philippine Port Authority.
Plaza Mexico.
Plaza Mexico.
Pasok na ng
Intramuros. Oh, papasok na tayo ng Intramuros. Siyempre, kailangan natin kuhaan yan. Woo! Ay na, nakakita na ako ng mga bus. Wow! Ito ang wall ng Intramuros. Tayo?
Sa Grand Procession.
Yon, sa Grand Procession. Kakarating lang namin dito, guys.
Yeah. Medyo nakakapagod.
Pagalitan na naman ako.
Medyo nakakapagod, pero worth it naman.
Yan, yeah, napin natin yung iba natin kasama sa Our Lady of Mercy.
Yes. Go!
Bye-bye.
Bye.
See you later. Sanctus Ministry. Sama ko kanilang Mommy Patty.
Isa
lang payong namin. Buti na lang may dala ang dakilang si Martin.
Dalaran niyo ako, guys. Hi, everyone.
Gulito-gulito. O, yung laki ng ano.
Laki ng?
Yung ano na. Balcon holder.
Ay, akala ko ito.
Ang gaganda ng mga berhen.
Tayo po dati.
Nahanap natin sila.
Wala pa kata sila.
Andito na daw.
Nasa may Lyceum daw.
Sige. Hanapin muna namin sila. Ciao. Ganda ng pan-selfie, oh.
Sorry ng ano niya.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, let us and let's put ourselves in the presence of God, and as we remember our brethren who have passed away during the time of the pandemic, particularly the members of the Compradia de la Immaculada Concepcion. In the name of the Father, who does not Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Let us pray. Lord God, Almighty Father, you have made the cross for us as a sign of strength and marked us as yours in the sacrament of the resurrection. Now that you have freed our brothers and sisters, Jorge Alan Tempo, Joselito Tempo, Conrado A. Escudero, Zita Feliciano, Esther Vivar, Victoria Huda de Tempo, Baby Javelosa, Corazon M. Dali, Griselda Flonco, Ricard Kernel, Elvira Tunez, Karen Makasari, June F. Pablo, and Reverend Father Aloysius Alini. Make them on with your saints, be with your saints in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. May we call on our bishop, presider, His Excellency Bishop Dennis C. Villarojo, Bishop of Manolos, to lead us in the opening prayer for our procession.
Salve Regina. Santa Dei Genitrix. Oremus, omnipotens paterni Deus, qui gloriosae Virginis Matris Mariae corpus et animam, ut dignum filii tui habitaculum in vece merire tu, Spiritu Sancto cooperanti preparasti, daut cuius cum in oratione laetamur, eius pia intercessione, ab instantibus malis, et a morte perpetua liberemur. Per iundem Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Divinum auxilium maniat semper nobis.
We call on our Grand Marshal, Commander of the Fleet Marine Ready Force of the Philippine Navy, Brigadier General Edwin E. Amada.
Led the 41st Grand Marian Procession of Intramuros in the modern times, in honor of our national patroness, the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, commence!
Thank you to our Grand Marshal of the 41st Grand Marian Procession, Brigadier General Edwin E. Amadar, Commander, Fleet Marine Ready Force of the Philippine Navy. Marshal leads the Grand Marian Procession every year. This symbolizes the partnership with the armed forces of the Philippines. For the Philippine National Anthem. Of the Virgin, the Papal flag, the Cofradía de la Inmaculada Concepción Incorporated flag, and the Intramuros Administration flag. Also following is a contingent from the Philippine Navy, of which our Grand Marshal is part of, being the commander of the Fleet Marine Ready Force of the Philippine Navy. Grand Marshal Brigadier General Edwin E. Amadar. Following is a contingent from the Philippine Army.
Thank you.
Air Force. Leading our procession is the Philippine Navy Band. Governor Bobby Kuwa of Catanduanes, Captain Leopoldo T. Arcilia Sr., and Mrs. Leonida C. Arcilia, and the Eagle Clark Shipping Philippines Incorporated. San Andres! Feeling unworthy of dying in the same manner as the Savior, he asked for another form of crucifixion, thus the X-shaped cross of St. Andrew. The Spanish victory over the Chinese invader Limahong was attributed to St. Andrew's intercession. He was proclaimed the special protector of Intramuros in 1589 and the patron saint of the city of Manila. This image is under the care of the Tenco family and owned by the late Alan Tenco, former president of the Cofradía de la Inmaculada Concepción Incorporated. Thank you to the Tenco, Rodriguez Tenco family of Baliwag, Bulacan for the participation of San Jose, Patron de la Iglesia Universal. And again, we remember Alan George Tenco. Thank you. measuring the participation of the image. To our devotees from Hagonoy, Bulacan for accompanying the image. Also, we would like to thank Father Jose Rodol Ponce, the parish priest, the National Shrine of St. Anne, Diocese of Malolos. Santa Ana y Niña María de Hagonoy. Originally with the image of Saint Joachim, the images of St. Anne and the Child Mary are enshrined at the parish church in Hagonoy, Bulacan, established by the Augustinians in 1581. Every Tuesday, the relic of St. Anne is brought out for veneration and borne in a dawn procession. A fluvial procession is held on the Saturday preceding the feast day of Apo Ana at Virgen Maria na Hagonoy on July 26. Thank you again to our friends from Hagonoy, Bulacan, from the National Shrine of St. Anne, Diocese of Malolos. From Hagonoy, Bulacan. We have a large contingent from Hagonoy. Sa pambansang Dambana at parokya ni Santa Ana sa Hagonoy, Bulacan sa pagdalo nyo sa Intramuros para sa 41st Grand Marian Procession. Thank you. salamat ulit. Santa Ana Ininya Maria de Hagonoy, kasama ng mga taga Hagonoy. Our Lady and its devotion in his novel Noli Me Tangere. Even our national artists like Kidlat Tahimik, Nick Joaquin, Alejandro R. Rosas, and Larry Z. Alcala featured this image in their works. On May 24, 1953, this image was crowned episcopally by the Archbishop of Lipa. Salamat po sa Banda Uno mula sa Pakil, Laguna. The rites of Conan canonization of the Nuestra Señora de los Dolores de Turumba is scheduled on September 15, 2023. Viva la Virgen! Pupunta po tayo sa canonical coronation next year. Salamat sa Banda 1 at Banda 2 mula sa Pakil, Laguna. Buong bayan ng sa Intramuros ngayon para samahan ang Nuestra Señora de los Dolores de Turumba. Salamat po, Banda 2 mula sa Pakil. President Sara Zimmerman Duterte. would like to remind you that the legend about the Virgin dates back to 1640 when fishermen came upon a sheet of tin floating on the waters of Laguna de Bayo. It was an oil painting of Our Lady of Sorrows encased in a wood and silver frame. The fishermen brought it to the church, whereupon the priest ordered the carving of an ivory statue based on the portrait. Nuestra Señora de la Merced de Tarlac. We await the arrival of the image from the diocesan shrine and parish Nuestra Señora de la Merced de Tarlac, Barangay Matalahalin, Tarlac City. This image was given by the Dayarit family of Pampanga to military chaplain Father Conrado Quimbao in 1955. She was declared the Virgin of the Diocese when the Diocese of Tarlac was created in 1963. During restoration of the image in Pampanga in 1993, it got lost and another image was made. In 2012, a photo of the original image surfaced on social media. Father Jojo Cerudo found the image in an antique shop in Metro Manila. He bought the image and it was returned home to Tarlac in time for her 60th feast day in 2015. Parish priest, Reverend Father Jesus Dagasin, from the Diocesan Shrine and Parish of Nuestra Señora de la Merced, Tarlac City, Tarlac. Also, we would like to thank the Malabon Scouts, Drum and Lyre Corps. Intramuros para samahan ang kanilang patron. Nuestra Señora de la Merced de la ciudad de Tarlac, coronada. This image was given by the Dairit family of Pampanga to military chaplain Father Conrado Quiambao in 1955. She was declared the Virgin of the Diocese, and the Diocese of Tarlac was created in 1963. During restoration of the image in Pampanga in 1993, it got lost and another image was made. In 2012, a photo of the original image surfaced on social media. Father Jojo Cerundo found the image in an antique shop in Metro Manila. He bought it and the image returned home to Tarlac in time for her 60th feast day in 2015. Thank you to the parish priest, Reverend Father Jesus R. Gragasin, the Tarlac provincial government, and the Cofradía de Nuestra Señora de la Merced.
Viva! Viva! Coronada! Viva! Viva! Coronada!
Mary, help of Christians. From the National Shrine of Mary Help of Christians Parish, Better Living, Parañaque City. We would like to thank the parish priest, Father Crisostomo Eugenio V. Magitang. The image was canonically crowned, is going to be canonically crowned in 2022. The original statue was brought to Manila from Italy in 1922 by Archbishop William Piani, a Salesian Apostolic Delegate to the Philippines. First enthroned at the Manila Cathedral, the image was brought to Our Lady of Loreto Church in Sampaloc for safekeeping during World War II. The title Mary Help of Christians was first used by St. John Chrysostom in the year 345, along with St. John Bosco, who propagated the same devotion. We would like to thank the Armed Forces of the Philippines General Headquarters Band for providing the fanfare for our 41st Grand Marian Procession. The AFPGHQ Band is led by Technical Sergeant Gomer M. Doblada of the Philippine Army. Maraming salamat po, as always. Procession is organized by the Intramuros Administration and the Cofradía de la Inmaculada Concepción Incorporated. Nuestra Señora Patrocinio de María. Thank you. from the Nuestra Señora Patrocinio de Maria Parish, Bolhoon Church, Poblacion, Bolhoon, Cebu Province. Welcome to Intramuros for the 41st Grand Marian Procession. We would like to thank Monsignor Arturo Navales from Poblacion, Bolhoon, Cebu. The image feast day is on the second Saturday of November, and it was canonically crowned on April 23, 2022. We would like to acknowledge the former mayor of Bolhoon, Cebu. Arrived in 1599 in the coastal town of the Bulho, Cebu province, now known as the municipality of Bulhoon. When the ivory image, known as Chinita, was brought to Manila for repair in 1875, a replica was made and called Mestiza. Both images were on the ship back to Cebu when severe weather forced the captain to unload cargo. An Augustinian priest gathered the passengers to pray before the Virgin until the seas calmed and they all arrived safely in Cebu. Maraming salamat po, Nuestra Señora Patrocinio de Maria of Bolhoon, Cebu.
Nuestra Señora de la Merced de Tobaliche. Of Our Lady is from the Diocesan Shrine and Parish of Our Lady of Mercy, Diocese of Novaliches in Quezon City. The feast day of the image is celebrated every September 24. It was canonically crowned in 2021. And we would like to thank and acknowledge Congressman Annie Rosa Susano, Councilors Joe and Sion, Visaya and Family, Pascual Liner, Lala Taupa, Teacher Emma Estacio and Family, and Father Jose Museo Buen Viaje Foundation. Of Reverend Father Jose Peregrino Tomas. Again, Nuestra Señora de la Merced de Novaliches. Lieutenant General Vicente Bartolome Bacaro, Flag Officer in Command, Philippine Navy, Rear Admiral Toribio D. Adasi Jr., Commanding General of the Philippine Army, Lieutenant General Romeo S. Bronner Jr., and the Commander General of the Philippine Air Force, Lieutenant General Conor Anthony D. Canlas Sr., and our Grand Marshal, Brigadier General Edwin E. Amada, and Commander Fleet Marine Ready Force of the Philippine Navy. The Intramuros Grand Marian Procession is an opportunity for us to see some of the finest examples of the Blessed Virgin in art. We see an array of forms and media, from prints to paintings to bas-relief to sculptures in the round. We need to understand that these are representations and interpretations of one and the same persona, the Blessed Virgin Mary. From the Baliches, we will be welcoming Our Lady from Tarlac. As the late 16th century, the stand of the Philippine Catholic Church was to accept the doctrine of the Immaculate Conception as an article of faith, even while it was still permissible to question Anne's sinless conception of Mary. In fact, this was a primary factor in the endorsement of Pope Gregory XIII to build the Manila Cathedral consecrated to the conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary in 1578. After Pope Paul V declared that the doctrine was no longer open to question or public rebuttal, the first national celebration of the devotion to the Immaculate Conception was held in the country in 1690. On December 8, the first of the 15-day event, festivities were held at the Manila Cathedral. The procession was only one of countless activities that included bullfights, masquerades, carnivals, parades, band and chorale concerts and stage shows. Fireworks and the pealing of church bells all over the city set off much of the revelry. We would like to acknowledge members, the officers of the Cofradía de la Inmaculada Concepción for 2019 to 2022, for the ordinary chairperson, His Eminence Luis Antonio G. Cardinal Tagle, the chairperson Danilo El Dolor, vice chairperson Aurora Ismendi, the president Lourdes T. Castañeda. Mater Dolorosa de Tarlac. The seven sorrows of Mary are depicted by the seven daggers piercing her heart. The causes of her sorrow are Simon's prophecy, the Holy Family's flight into Egypt, the loss of Jesus in Jerusalem, Christ's journey to Calvary, the crucifixion, the deposition from the cross, and the burial of Christ. The image of Mater Dolorosa is from the Diocese of Tarlac, with the parish priest, Father Melvin B. Castro. I would like to welcome the parishioners of the Mater Dolorosa Parish from Barangay Dolores, Cabas, Tarlac. Thank you for coming to Intramuros. The Feast Day of Our Lady is celebrated on September 15. Last June 5, 2021, this image was canonically crowned. The Grand Marian Procession is not only a celebration of Marian art and devotion, it is also a celebration of Filipino culture. Through the commendable efforts of our participants, who prepared for days and tirelessly worked till late night or under the scorching sun, we get a glimpse of how communities celebrate their fiestas. We are treated to an array of costumes, music, dances, rituals and chants, and in some instances, even cuisine. They are expressions of a people's identity and form part of our heritage. Thank you, Music Foundation Band from Amono Rizal, accompanying Our Lady of Sorrows. Subsequently, nationwide festivities lasted for a year. De la Inmaculada Concepción officers, we acknowledge the Treasurer, Maria Victoria T. Burgos, the Assistant Treasurer, Fe S. Rodriguez, the Auditor, Serena O. Camus, and the Board Secretary, Armando M. Arionde. Nuestra Señora de Lourdes.
¡Viva! ¡Viva! ¡Viva!
This is the first replica of the Virgin originally enshrined at the Church of the Capuchin Fathers in Intramuros. She is depicted as she appeared to Bernadette Soubirous at Lourdes, France in 1858. The original image survived the Second World War, but the church did not. It is now enshrined at Our Lady of Lourdes Church in Canlaon, Quezon City. Our local altar includes a statue of Saint Bernadette on her knees. The image of Our Lady is from the National Shrine of Our Lady of Lourdes from the Diocese of Cubao, Quezon City, with Parish Priest Reverend Father Jefferson Agustin, OFM Cup. Her feast day is on February 11, and she was canonically crowned in 2020. We acknowledge the National Shrine of Our Lady of Lourdes Parish Pastoral Council and the Art Confraternity of Our Lady of Lourdes Philippines.
Viva! Viva! Viva!
the Grand Marian Procession gathers together images of the Blessed Virgin Mary in the care of shrines, parishes, and private individuals from all over the Philippines. The event is held in Intramuros every first Sunday of December, though the actual Marian feast day is December 8th. Sunday was chosen to give the general public a better opportunity to witness the event. The annual event and the celebration was revived only in 1954 when President Ramon Magsaysay led the first Marian procession in Manila. This procession, which assembled some 60 venerated images of the Blessed Virgin from all over the country, established the standards for today's feast day celebration. Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Early in the 13th century, Latin hermits settled on Mount Carmel and started the Carmelite order devoted to the Blessed Virgin Mary. The Virgin allegedly appeared to Simon Stock, the general superior of the Carmelite order, and handed the brown scapular as a symbol of her protection to the order, which took her as patroness and queen. The devotion to Our Lady and her brown scapular is quite popular in the Philippines. The image of Our Lady is from the Diocese of Cubao. The Reverend Father Willowin Noel Andaya, OCD, as parish priest. The image of Our Lady was canonically crowned in 2020. We wish to acknowledge the Basilica of the National Shrine of Mount Carmel in New Manila, Quezon City. With the image are the OCD flyers and brothers, Father Gerald Reno Ramos, Confraternity of Brown Scapular of the Blessed Virgin Mary and Mount Carmel Youth and the BBC. Materials employed to produce these Marian images vary: paint on paper or canvas, polychrome wood or stone, as well as ivory. Ivory is revered as the most precious medium, valued for its rarity and its ability to be carved finely up to the smallest details. For wood, batikuling is most favored for its right density and its best resisting properties. After carving, the wood is then polychromed in a process called encarnacion, giving it a lifelike appearance. This process may also apply to other media of sculpture. Religious images are crafted to inspire prayer and devotion and reflect the splendor of heaven. As Pope Pius IX proclaimed in 1844, the Most Blessed Virgin Mary was, from the first moment of her conception, by a singular grace and privilege of Almighty God, and by virtue of the merits of Jesus Christ, Savior of the human race, preserved immune from all stain of original sin. In 1760, Pope Clement XIII authorized the celebration of the Immaculate Conception in the Philippines as a feast, having proclaimed Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, the principal patroness of Spain and the Indies. From then on, this celebration became an annual tradition. Pope Pius IX defined the dogma of the Immaculate Conception and instituted the December 8 feast in 1854. Subsequently, nationwide festivities lasted for a year. The Grand Marian Procession gathers together images of the Blessed Virgin Mary in the care of shrines, parishes, and private individuals from all over the Philippines. The event is held in Intramuros every first Sunday of December, though the actual Marian feast day is December 8. Sunday was chosen to give the general public a better opportunity to witness the event. Torojas used to assemble inside San Agustin Church until space constraints and the rising number of images called for an alternative venue. It was for Tituos, but Fort Santiago was turned over to IAA from the National Parks Development Committee in 1992. The assembly area was moved to Plaza Moriones in Fort Santiago, and the start of the procession was transferred to the Manila Cathedral Basilica, where the event was actually first held in 1619. To make the decoration of the Carrozas more visible to more people, A. Soriano Avenue, or Aduana, is currently used as assembly area. The procession winds through the Intramuros streets. It used to pass through E. Burgos Drive and end at the Carino Grandstand at Rizal Park. The growing number of participants, however, made it wiser to limit the route within the Intramuros walls. La Purísima Concepción! Image of Our Lady is under the care of the Minor Basilica Parish of La Purísima Concepción, Santa Maria. We acknowledge the parish family from Santa Maria, Bulacan. The Minor Basilica and Parish of La Purísima Concepción is under Reverend Monsignor Alberto Suatenco, Parish Priest. And with the image, we acknowledge Santa Maria Fiesta Committee 2023 and Lourdes Perez and family. This image is said to have protected the town of Santa Maria Bulacan from bandits during the Spanish colonial period. The image disappeared for 30 years, during which the church was damaged by an earthquake and the town was burned in the Philippine-American War. Legend has it that the Virgin was found in Gapan, Nueva Ecija, and her return to Santa Maria kept the town safe during the Second World War. Thank you, Banda 31, original of Santa Maria, Bulacan, Incorporated. The procession winds through the interior streets and used to pass through people who strike at the end of the Carino Grandstand. The growing number of participants, however, made it wiser to limit the route within the Intramuros walls. For a time, the procession ended at Fort Santiago, where a mass was held. But the saying, "Kay haba-haba man ang prosesyon sa simbahan ni Troy, Tuvema," the procession now ends in front of Manila Cathedral Basilica, although the Mass is held 2 hours before the procession. The Inchicoros Grand Marian Procession is an opportunity for us to see some of the finest examples of the Blessed Virgin in art. We see an array of forms and media, from prints to paintings to bas-relief to sculptures in the round. We need to understand that these are representations and interpretations of one and the same persona, the Blessed Virgin Mary. As these become objects of devotion, their significance deepens as they evolve into signifiers of faith and love, as well as history and culture. Thus, these images represent both Mary and the people who deeply love. December, though the actual Marian feast day is December 8th.
Sunday was chosen to give the general public a better opportunity to witness the event. Nuestra Señora de la Rosa de Makati. Also known as the Virgen de la Rosa de Makati, the devotion to Our Lady started when in 1718, Father Juan Jose Delgado, S.J., brought the image from Acapulco, Mexico to the ports of Manila and enthroned it in San Pedro Makati Church. Unique to the devotion to the Virgen de la Rosa is the Baile de los Arcos or Panatang Sayaw. Nine maidens recite prayers and sing and dance in honor of Makati's patrona. With the image was canonically crowned in 2019 and the feast celebrated on June 13. It is from the Saints Peter and Paul Parish from the Archdiocese of Manila in Makati City, Metro Manila, with Reverend Father Hilario Diwa as parish priest. We acknowledge the Makati City Band accompanying Virgen de la Rosa de Makati. The tricentennial jubilee of the arrival of the Virgen de la Rosa was celebrated in 2018 and was highlighted by the granting of the approval for the pontifical coronation by Pope Francis. These ceremonies were solemnly enacted on March 16, 2019 by then Papal Nuncio Gabriel Giordano Cascia, His Eminence Luis Antonio Cardinal Tagle, and His Eminence Gaudencio Cardinal Rosales, then Archbishop of Manila. The Virgen de la Rosa de Makati, the crown jewel of Makati, is the only canonically crowned Marian image in the city of Makati, venerated at the Saints Peter and Paul Parish, Poblacion, Makati. Virgen de la Rosa de Makati, Coronada, pray for us. We would like to acknowledge Reverend Father Renato Odiwa, Parish Priest, the Parish Pastoral Council of Saints Peter and Paul Parish, the Cofradia de la Virgen de la Rosa de Makati, Barangay Commission of Avengers Band, Public Safety Department Man, Honorable Marlene Abigail Binay Campos, City Mayor, Honorable Monique Yasmin Lantemeo, City Vice Mayor, Honorable Romulo Keith Peña Jr., Congressman of the 1st District, Honorable Luis Campos, Congressman 2nd District, Honorable Jose Villanueva, Honorable Alcina Yang, Honorable Denver Elmos and Barangay Provision Council and Barangay staff and committees, and Honorable Juliet Kyle G. San Mateo. Once again, thank you for the shares of Saints Peter and Paul Parish of the Archdiocese. Thank you. late 16th century, the stand of the Philippine Catholic Church was to accept the doctrine of the Immaculate Conception as an article of faith. We acknowledge the El Gobernador Band from the city of Bacoor, Cavite. Disrupted the annual event, and the celebration was revived only in 1954, when President Ramon Magsaysay led the first Marian procession in Manila. This procession, which assembled some 60 venerated images of the Blessed Virgin from all over the country, established the standards for today's feast day celebration. Administration, or IA, became involved with the Marian celebrations as part of its official functions to sponsor, conduct, or otherwise assist and support festivals and cultural activities in Intramuros. Starting in 1980, IA, then under the Ministry of Human Settlements and headed by Action Officer Dr. Jaime Silaya, mounted the Grand Marian Procession annually with the Cofradía de la Inmaculada Concepción Incorporated. Originally known as the Cofradía de Damas y Caballeros de la Inmaculada Concepción, led by founding chair Imelda Ochoa. Cardinal Tagler as honorary chairperson, Mr. Danilo L. Lenor, chairperson, Ms. Aurora E. Smendi, vice chairperson, Ms. Lourdes D. Casaneda, president, Ms. Maria Victoria T. Burgos, treasurer, Ms. Fe S. Rodriguez, assistant treasurer, Ms. Zarina O. Camus, author, and Ms. Armando M. Alionda, as board secretary.
attend the AFP contingent for Grand Marian Procession for 2023. Considering all units from the Philippine Army, Philippine Navy, the Philippine Air Force, NDPNPR, and VIPD, de Puerto Vaga. Monitoring ground image, Nuestra Señora de la Ciudad de Puerto Vaga, also Braga, San Roque, Cavite City. We would like to thank the Intramuros administration with officer in charge Edgardo Vesey, Lisandra Martinez as the chief of Tourism Promotions Division and chairperson of the Grand Mayan Procession Working Committee, and Mr. Jeffrey Yap, the officer in charge of the Urban Planning and Community Development Division, vice chairperson of the Grand Mayan Procession Working Committee.
Nuestra Señora del Pilar de Moro. In 1578, the town of Morong became part of the Corregimiento de Mariveles, together with Bagac and Maragondon, Cavite. But it was only in 1607 that Moron was officially founded as a town and parish by Father Rodrigo del San Miguel. He placed them under the protection of Our Lady of the Pillar. The image received an episcopal crown as decreed by His Eminence, Roberto C. Santos, Bishop of the Diocese of Malaga, on October 12, 2017, and was canonically crowned on October 10, 2018, under the present pontificate of Pope Francis. We would like to thank the Our Lady of Del Pilar Parish, Morong, Bataan, the Diocese of Malaga City, as well as the Banda Uno for Banda Uno Kabataan 2001, as well as the Parish Pastoral Council of Pilar Parish. As president, Maria Victoria T. Borges as treasurer, Fez Rodriguez as Assistant Treasurer, Sarina Ocamos as Auditor, and Armando M. Ariunday as Board Secretary. La Virgen Milagrosa de Bado, Nuestra Señora, causa de la nuestra alegría. Viva la Virgen! The original image was found with the image of Santo Cristo in Milagroso in the cove of the village of Lago, Tarlacitin, at the border of Sinay de la Cusur and Bado de Ilocos Norte. A legend tells that the image of the Virgin was destined to be enshrined in Bado while the Santo Cristo was headed for Sinai. Patroness of Ilocos Norte, the Virgin is believed to have been brought to Bado as a reward for the Ilocanos' fervent devotion to Mary. Her canonical coronation was on December 8, 1918. This image is from the St. Joseph by St. John the Baptist Catholic Parish of Bado, Ilocos Norte, and we would like to thank Very Reverend Father Joel Reynold Castillo, as well as the Minor Basilica and Parish of St. John the Baptist, Shrine of the La Virgen Milagrosa de Bado. We'd also like to thank the delegates and devotees of La Virgen Milagrosa de Bado. The Virgin was canonically crowned in 2018 and her feast day is on May 31. Nuestra Señora del Pilar de Manila. Viva la Virgen. This is an replica of the original one in Zaragoza, Spain, brought to the Philippines by the Jesuits in 1768. The Virgin became the titular patroness of Santa Cruz, Manila, by the middle of the 19th century. Two other major shrines of the Virgin of the Pilar in the Philippines are in Zamboanga and in Pilar, Bataan. In 1960, Pope John XXIII proclaimed Nuestra Señora del Pilar as the patroness of the Archdiocese of Zamboanga. We would like to thank Reverend Father Rudsen P. Paragas, as well as the Archdiocesan Shrine of the Blessed Sacrament, Santa Cruz Parish, Manila.
Viva! Viva!
We'd also like to thank the Parish Pastor and Council, the Confraria de la Nuestra Señora del Pilar de Manila, and all devotees of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Again, we'd like to thank the 600-strong AFP contingent for the Grand Marian Procession 2022. So, the contingent of the AFP is composed of the Philippine Army, the Philippine Navy, the Philippine Air Force, the NTG-NCR, JITG, CEI-SSAFP, JCMOTG, HSSG, JTF, NCR, JTF, NCR Command Group, as well as the JTG-SEV. The contingent is divided into the security elements, parading elements, and medical team. Thank you for gracing the Grand Marian Procession 2022. I'd also like to thank Major Sal Bagundol, Philippine Army, Staff Sergeant Jerome S. Magaduas, Philippine Air Force, Major Abdul Jalil D. Datumanong, Philippine Air Force, Staff Sergeant Christopher O. Palay, Philippine Army, Commander Jefferson L. Mateo, Philippine Navy, Major Benji A. Jimenez, Philippine Army, Lieutenant Colonel from Celeste J. Saison, Philippine Army, Second Lieutenant Nelion E. Ebio Jr., Philippine Air Force, Second Lieutenant Robert G. Queta, Philippine Navy, Major Edison M. Lutilia, Major Christian Peter G. Sagat, Philippine Army, Lieutenant Colonel Roland M. Goricho, Major Hernan C. Capulo, Philippine Army, Technical Sergeant Neil C. Rubia, Philippine Air Force, Second Lieutenant Bautista, Sergeant Matog Jr., Technical Sergeant Pasco, and Sergeant Cacho. Meanwhile, the contingent for the Philippine Navy is headed by Captain Castillo, Technical Sergeant Congreso, and Technical Sergeant as well as Technical Sergeant Congreso. For the Philippine Air Force, the contingent is led by Second Lieutenant Eleazar, Staff Sergeant Presente, Technical Sergeant Cariaga, and Hernandez. For the NTG-NCR, the contingent is led by Major Desingano, Lieutenant Commander Corpus.
Señora de Aranzazú.
The Nuestra Señora de Aranzazu is from the Diocesan Shrine and Parish of Nuestra Señora de Aranzazu from San Mateo Rizal. In the 15th century, a lady with an infant in her arms appeared before a shepherd in the mountains of Bologna, Spain. She urged the shepherd to tell his carpenter father to build a shrine on the site and named it Aranzazu. Immediately after, the shepherd found a stone carving with a name on top of it. In the Philippines, the shrine of Our Lady of Aranzazu is found in San Mateo Rizal. The confraternity was established on the Bulay of San Juan de Lebran in Intramuros in 1833. The Reverend Father Rodrigo Arrodilla, as well as the Diocesan Shrine and Parish of Nuestra Señora de Aranzazu and the Diocese of Antipolo. The feast day of Our Lady of Aranzazu is on September 9, and the image was canonically crowned in 2017 under the present pontificate of Pope Francis. Reverend Father Rodrigo Iguia, who is the parish priest and shrine rector, who is joined by the Honorable Mayor Bartolome Rivera, accompanied by Vice Mayor Jimmy Rojas, together with the Sangguniang Bayan and the 15 barangay captains. The Hermana Mayor, 2023, of the delegation from Aranzazu is Mrs. Arthlyn Fetalvero, and Hermana Menor is Miss Ana Santos. Gathers together images of the Blessed Virgin Mary in the care of shrines, parishes, and private individuals. Nuestra Señora del Pilar de Limanan, Viva la Virgen! Virgen del Pilar de Limanan is from the parish and shrine of Our Lady of the Pilar in San Isidro, Limanan, Camarines Sur. The image shows the Virgin standing on a pillar with a child Jesus in her arms. Devotion began when the image of the Virgin atop a jasper pillar appeared to St. James the Apostle. The parish in San Isidro, Limanan, Camarines Sur was established in 1985. Since then, miracles have been attributed to the image which was canonically crowned in 2015. We would like to thank the parish priest of Limanan, Reverend Father Romulo Castaneda, and we'd also like to thank the caretaker of the image, Mr. Junel San Diego. Her feast day is on October 12. Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
In 1760, Pope Clement XIII authorized the celebration of the Immaculate Conception in the Philippines as a feast, having proclaimed Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception the principal patroness of Spain and the Indies. From then on, this celebration became an annual tradition. Pope Pius IX refined the dogma of the Immaculate Conception and instituted the December 8th feast in 1854. Subsequently, national festivities lasted for a year. After Pope Paul VI declared that the doctrine was no longer open to question or public rebuttal, the first national celebration of the devotion to the Immaculate Conception was held in the country in 1619. On December 9, the first of the 15-day event festivities were held at the Manila Cathedral. The procession was only one of the countless activities that included bullfights, masquerades, carnivals, parades, band and choral concerts, as well as stage shows. Fireworks and the pealing of church bells all over the city set off much of the revelry. Again, we'd like to thank the Armed Forces of the Philippines, led by Chief of Staff AFP Lieutenant General Vicente Bartolome Bacaro, the Flag Officer in Command of the Philippine Navy, Rear Admiral Toribio D. Adachi Jr., Commanding General Philippine Army Lieutenant General Romeo S. Bronner Jr., and the Commanding General of the Philippine Air Force Lieutenant General Colonel Anthony D. Canlas Sr.
We would also like to acknowledge the Working Committee of the Intramuros Administration for the 41st Grand Marian Procession, led by our Officer in Charge, Edgardo A. Baisik, Vice Chairperson Jeffrey Yap, Head of the Deployment Committee, Anasubion Taganas and Arnel Guillermo, Procession Marshalling, Vicente Santos Jr. and Bernard Jose, Physical Arrangement, Architect Eunice Lim, Technical Requirements, Leonardo Hugo and Mark J. Rita, the Secretariat headed by Estrelita Go and John Rancho Arcilia. For Area Improvement, Lucinia Bernardo.
Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe de Cebu, Viva la Virgen! Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe de Cebu is from the Archdiocesan Shrine of the Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe de Cebu in Cebu City. The Familia Mendez serves as camarero. The family is from Punta Princesa, Cebu City. In 1880, a chicken trapper followed the light coming from a cave. beside the river in Guadalupe, Cebu. He found a statue of the Virgin Mary, and the image was brought to the makeshift chapel, which eventually became the church. This is one of the four distinct images bearing the title of Guadalupe. The others came from Mexico, Spain, and the Canary Islands. Our Lady is the patroness of Cebu. We'd like to thank the caretaker of the image, Mr. Ellis Manuel Mendez, from the Mendez family of Cebu City, as well as the parish priest, Reverend Father Aloysius Alucipan, of the Archdiocese and Shrine of Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe de Cebu, the Primera Fiesta is on December 12, while the Thanksgiving Fiesta is on July 16. The image was crowned, canonically crowned on July 16, 2006, under the pontificate of His Holiness, Benedict XVI. And I'd also like to acknowledge Reverend Father Junel Fuentes, Secretary to the Archbishop of Cebu, as well as the devotees from the Commission on Youth and the Archdiocese of Cebu, and the devotees from the shrines and parishes of Cebu.
To continue the acknowledgement of the Working Committee of the Intramuros Administration for the 41st Grand Marian Procession, for the assembly venue management, we have Engineer Victor Reyes and Clark Topacio. For area improvement, Lucinia Bernardo. For images and paraphernalia, Mr. Dino Carlos Santos. For technical requirements, Leonardo Hugo and Mark J. Rita. For security and traffic management, Jeff Ria. For physical arrangement, Architect Eunice Lim. For deployment, Engineer Anasumbion Taganas and Arnel Guillermo. For procession marshalling, Vicente Santos Jr. and Bernard Jose. Also, the secretariat is headed by Estrelita Go and John Rancho Arcilla. The Intramuros administration is headed by its officer in charge, Edgardo A. Baisi.
As Pope Pius IX proclaimed in 1844, the Blessed Virgin Mary was, for the first moment of her conception, by a singular grace and privilege of Almighty God, and by the virtue of the merits of Jesus Christ, Savior of the human race, preserved, immune from all stains of original sin.
Thank you.
The Armed Forces of the Philippines contingent is led by the Chief of Staff of the AFP, Lieutenant General Vicente Bartolome Macaro. We would like to thank the devotees from Marikina. Good evening po. Our Lady of the Abandon, Birhen ng Marikina. Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
The Virgen de Marikina is from the Diocese of Shrine and Parish of Our Lady of the Abandon of Marikina. The image was canonically crowned on 2005 under the pontificate of His Holiness Pope Benedict XVI. We would like to thank Bishop Noli Buco as well as Reverend Father Lamberto Ramos. The caretaker of the image is Sister Herminia Digmaco de Guzman Cruz. The image before us is an original image from the early 20th century, and the feast day is every second Sunday of May. The image was canonically crowned on October 23, 2001 under the pontificate of His Holiness Benedict XVI. Devotion to the Virgin started in the 15th century in Valencia, Spain, when a priest drew attention to the insane, whom he called the abandoned children of God. An organization was formed and named after the lady, after which funds were raised for the hospital for the insane. A replica of the image was brought to the Philippines by the Franciscans, who established a mission of the Church of San Pedro. We'd like to thank the Parañaque City Band of the City Government of Parañaque.
Buen suceso.
Diocesan Shrine of Nuestra Señora del Buen Suceso, Diocese of Parañaque, with Reverend Father Augusto C. Pulido as Parish Priest. We acknowledge the Cofradía of Nuestra Señora del Buen Suceso, the devotees of Nuestra Señora del Buen Suceso, the parishioners of the Cathedral Parish of St. Andrew, the Parañaque City Band, and Parañaque City Tourism's Office. The image of Our Lady was canonically crowned on September 8, 2000 under the pontificate of Pope St. John Paul II. The image was discovered by a priest in 1625 when he heard the confession of a poor dying man at his home, Domalo Parañaque. The small dark statue stood between two canes and more simple ornaments. After the man died, the image was given to the priest who brought it to St. Andrew's Church in Parañaque, where it remains to this day. The Feast of Our Lady of Good Events was celebrated August 10th. Early as the late 16th century, the stand of the Philippine Catholic Church was to accept the doctrine of the Immaculate Conception as an article of faith, even while it was still permissible to question Anne's sinless conception of Mary. In fact, this was a primary factor in the endorsement of Pope Gregory XIII to build the Manila Cathedral consecrated to the conception of the Blessed Virgin in 1578. In 1716, Pope Clement XIII authorized the celebration of the Immaculate Conception in the Philippines as a feast, having proclaimed Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception the principal patroness of Spain and the Indies. From then on, this celebration became an annual tradition. Pope Pius IX defined the dogma of the Immaculate Conception and instituted the December 8th feast in 1854. Subsequently, nationwide festivities lasted for a year. Thank you, Sir Al's Music and Art Studio, Bukawe Youth Concert Band 16, from Bukawe, Bulacan. Our Lady is from the Basilica Minore de San Sebastian from the Archdiocese of Manila. We acknowledge the Cofradía de la Nuestra Señora del Carmen, the Cofradía de Tancillo de Nuestra Señora, the Order of the Augustinian Recollects, and the Secular Augustinian Recollect Fraternity. Feast of Our Lady is celebrated on January 29 and July 16, and it was canonically crowned in 1991 by popes under the pontificate of Pope St. John Paul II. Passing through Mexico on the way to the Philippines in 1617, the local convention of the Recollect Fathers visited the convent of the Carmelite Fathers, who gave him a statue of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Upon arriving in the Philippines, the Recollect Fathers built a church for the image. Devotees honored her by wearing a brown dress along with her scarf. Once again, thank you, parishioners and devotees of Nuestra Señora Nuestra del Carmen de San Sebastián, of the Basilica Minore de San Sebastián in Manila. Established the standards for today's feast day celebrations. The Intramuros Administration, or IA, became involved in the Marian celebrations as part of its official functions to sponsor, conduct, or otherwise assist and support festivals and cultural activities in Intramuros. Starting in 1988, IA, then under the Ministry of Human Settlements, led by Action Officer Dr. Jaime Sindaya, founded the Grand Marian Procession annually with the Compañía de la Inmaculada Concepción, originally known as the Compañía de Damas y Caballeros de la Inmaculada Concepción, led by Founding Chair Imelda Ocoa. The Intramuros Grand Marian Procession is an opportunity for us to see some of the finest examples of the Blessed Virgin in art. We see an array of forms in India, from prints to paintings to bas-relief to sculptures in Durango. We need to understand the beliefs and the associations and interpretations of one and the same person, the Blessed Virgin Mary. As these become objects of devotion, their significance differs as these evolve into signifiers of faith and love, as well as history and culture. Thus, these images represent both Mary and the people who deeply love her. Materials employed to produce these Marian images are made of paper or canvas, polychrome wood or stone, as well as ivory. Ivory is revered as the most precious medium, valued for its rarity and its ability to be carved finely up to the smallest of details. For wood, polychrome is most favored for its right density and its best resisting properties. After carving, the wood is then polychrome in a process called incarnation, giving it a lifelike process may also apply to other media of sculpture. Religious images are crafted to inspire prayer and devotion and reflect the splendor of the river. Welcome the devotees and parishioners of the National Nuestra Señora de los Desamparados de Manila. Our Lady of Urbano, Santa Ana, Manila, the Parish Priest and Reverend Father Virgilio del Mundo Jr. Accompanying the image is the Camareros de la Virgen, Cofradía de Nuestra Señora de los Desamparados de Manila, and its parishioners. Nuestra Señora de los Desamparados is celebrated on May 12. It was canonically crowned in 1991 under the pontificate of Pope St. John Paul II. A replica of the original enshrined in the cathedral in Valencia, Spain, this image was brought to the Philippines by Fray Vicente Inver. 1717 on the Galion Santo Cristo de Burgos. In 1720, Manila Archbishop Francisco de la Cuesta gave his gold and crystal baston de mando to the Virgin, and the cane has been held by the image since then. City of Manila Mayor Manny Lacuna and the Barangay Chairman of 654, 655, 656, 657, 658 in Intramuros, Manila. Procession winds through the Intramuros streets. It used to pass through P. Burgos Drive and end at the Camino Grandstand at Rizal Point. The growing number of participants, however, made it wiser to limit the route of the Intramuros walls. For a time, the procession ended at Fort Santiago, where a mass was held. But the same, the haba-haba man ang posisyon ng simbahan nilang tuloy prevailed. The procession now ends in front of Manila Cathedral Basilica, although the mass is held 2 hours before the procession. Marian procession is not only a celebration of Marian art and devotion, it is also a celebration of Filipino culture. Through the commendable efforts of our participants, who prepared for days and tirelessly worked till late night or under the scorching sun, we get a glimpse of how communities celebrate their fiestas. We are treated to an array of costumes, music, dances, rituals and chants, and in some instances, even cuisine. They are expressions of the people's identity and form part of our heritage. It is important to understand that these spectacles are not merely for show. They are unique expressions of love and devotion to Mary, and are all done for the greater glory of God. Once again, we would like to acknowledge the officers of the Cofradía de la Inmaculada Concepción from 2019 to 2022. His Eminence Luis Antonio G. Cardinal Tagle as Honorary Chairperson, Mr. Danilo L. Dolor as chairperson, Ms. Aurora E. Ismendi as vice chairperson, Ms. Lourdes T. Casaneda as president, Ms. Maria Victoria T. Burgos as treasurer, Ms. Pe S. Rodriguez as assistant treasurer, Ms. Irina O. Camus as auditor, and Ms. Armando. Mr. Armando M. Arionday as board secretary. Grand Marian Procession gathers together images of the Blessed Virgin Mary in the care of parishes, shrines, and private individuals from all over the Philippines. The event is held in Intramuros every first Sunday of December, though the actual Marian feast day is December 8th. Sunday was chosen to give the general public a better opportunity to witness the event. Isang puting bisita ang dali nang nagtayo sa Hacienda ng Bogog, Malabon, noong mga huling bahagi ng mga taong 1600. Ito ang naging bahay dalanginan ng mga taga Concepcion at tahanan ng magandang larawan ng Lapu-Rin Simang Concepcion, ang mahal na patrona ng nayong ito sa pagitan ng Ilog Malabon at Ilog Nabon.
Ako naman dito, Ted. Si Marvin naman.
Ngayon, Makulala, Concepcion de Malabon. We acknowledge the parish priest of the Diocesan Shrine and Parish of the Immaculate Conception, Reverend Father Joey C. Enriquez, together with Reverend Father Paul Nicolas Wu, and Brother Anthony Poma. The image was canonically crowned on December 7, 1986 under the pontificate of Pope St. John Paul II. Noong December 8, 1854, tinawag na Immaculada Concepcion ayon sa pagpakilala ng mahal na ina nang siya ay magpakita kay Santa Bernadita sa Lourdes o Immaculada Concepcion. September 8, 1907, ang Sito Concepcion ay ginawa ng isang parokya na ang titular at patrona ay ang Immaculada Concepcion. We acknowledge the Malabon Community Band accompanying the image of Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception of Malabon. Salvación de Joroan. Accompanying the image of Our Lady is the Diocesan Shrine of Nuestra Señora de Salvación Parish, Pastoral Council, and devotees from Joroan, TV Albay, and devotees from Metro Manila. Thank you. of Knowledge, Father Joseph Salando, Parish Priest of the Diocese and Shrine of Nuestra Senora del Salvacion from the Diocese of Legazpi, Binuroan, TV Albay, Legazpi. The Feast of Our Lady is celebrated on the third Saturday of August. Her image was canonically crowned on August 25, 1976 under the pontificate of Pope St. Paul VI. Diocesan Shrine of Nuestra Senora de Salvacion Parish Pastoral Council, the devotees from Moroan, TV Albay, and devotees from Metro Medina accompanying the image of Our Lady of Salvation. Is accompanied by the Sireneo ni Inang Peña, a Parish Pastoral Council of the Archdiocese and Shrine of Our Lady of Peña Francia de Manila, the Propagation and Devotion Ministry, and the Shrine Ministry, and of course, the OLP dancers. The assembly area was moved to Plaza Moriones in Fort Santiago, and the start of the procession was transferred to the Manila Cathedral Basilica, where the event was actually first held in 1690. Nuestra Señora de Peña Francia de Manila. Archdiocese and Shrine of Our Lady of Peña Francia in Franco, Manila, with Parish Priest Reverend Father Herbert John Camacho. The Feast of Our Lady is celebrated on May 14th, and her image was canonically crowned in 1985 under the pontificate of Saint John Paul II. We acknowledge and thank the presence of Cireneo ni Inang Peña, the Parish Pastoral Council of the Archdiocese and Shrine of Our Lady of Peña Francia, Manila, the Proclamation and Devotion Ministry, and the Shrine Ministry, and of course the OLP dancers. The Board of Directors of the Cofradía de la Inmaculada Concepción for 2019-2022. Maria Rosario A. Gardoni, Alice R. Briones, Maria Victoria T. Burgos, Gordes P. Castaneda, Danilo L. Dolor, Aurora E. Ismendi, Dr. Jaime C. Laya, Nene S. Leonor, Rosita S. Fonseca, Osama, Helen M. Ophelia M. Reco, and Fe S. Rodriguez. We also acknowledge and thank the 2022 Hermana and Hermano Mayor, Maria Victoria T. Burgos, and Danilo L. Dolor. Thank you. of the Cofradía de Nuestra Señora de la Candelaria. We would like to acknowledge the parish priest, Monsignor Jo Marie Delgado, and accompanying the image, our Father Rex John Palma, Father Paul Talavera, de la Cofradía de Nuestra Señora Virgen la Candelaria de Jaro, and the local delegates. Welcome to Intramuros, Ilongo delegates. The image of Our Lady is said to grow in size as a crown placed on her head will need adjustment every feast day. The distribution of perdón, apples, dedicated to Our Lady is one unique tradition in India. These candles are believed to be the Ilongo's weapon against natural calamities and disasters.
Espiritu Santo, nagatuwa ko sa Diyos na may mapagpala ko sa atalan. Pagduduha sa langit at sa duda, nagatuwa ko kay sa Kristo yana kabukto ka ko niyo. Ito na po sa lalang sa
Espiritu Santo. In fact, this was a primary problem in the enforcement of Thank you.
Torres and Clark Topacio, procession marshaling Vicente Santos Jr. and Bernard Jose, area improvement and readiness Ms. Lucinia Bernardo, images and paraphernalia Sir Nino Carlo Santos. La Virgen Divina Pastora.
Nuestra Señora de Navakpakan. Viva la Virgen.
Viva.
The images from the shrine of Our Lady of Namakpakan in St. Catherine of Alexandria Parish, Luna, La Union. The image was canonically crowned in 1959 under the pontificate of His Holiness Pope John the 23rd, and her feast is on November 24. We would like to thank the following: Reverend Father Norberto Benito El Collado of the St. Catherine of Alexandria Parish, as well as the Diocese of San Fernando of La Union. We'd also like to thank representatives from the local government unit, as well as parishioners and members of the confraternity of Our Lady of Namakpakan. This image is also known as Apo Baket, the Ilocano term of respect for an elderly woman. Made in Madrid, Spain, it was believed to have arrived in 1822 as the patroness of the Immaculate Conception Seminary in Vigan, Ilocos Sur. During a stopover at Namakpakan, La Union, the image stuck to its base and could not be removed. Church officials then decided to enthrone the image at the main altar and gave it the title Nuestra Señora de Namakpakan. Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
We'd like to thank the devotees and pilgrims from La Union. The image before us is the official pilgrim image. Maraming salamat. Again, we'd like to thank the City of Manila, Mayor Tony Lacuna, as well as the barangay chairpersons of 654, 655, 656, 657, and 658. We'd also like to thank the Red Cross for their assistance, the Philippine National Red Cross, of course. Thank you for your assistance. Also to the Board of Administrators of Intramuros, led by the Secretary of Tourism, the Honorable Cristina Frasco. I'd also like to thank the Bureau of the Treasury, headed by the National Treasurer, the Honorable Rosalia V. De Leon. Thank you as well to the Manila Cathedral, to the Archbishop Jose F. Cardinal Antipula, as well as the Director, Monsignor Rolando R. De La Cruz, and to the administrator and attached priest, Father Mario Noel Bayaras and Father Cali Pietra Lamado. The members of the Board of Directors of the Confraria de la Inmaculada Concepcion Incorporated for 2019-2022 are as follows: Maria Rosario Blardoni, Alice Briones, Lourdes Castañeda. Virgen Milagrosa del Rosario del Pueblo Orani. ¡Viva la Virgen! ¡Viva! The image is from the Minor Basilica and Shrine of Our Lady of the Rosary of Orani in Orani, Bataan. The image was crowned in 1959 under the pontificate of His Holiness Pope John XXIII, and before us is the official pilgrim image. The feast day of the Blessed Virgin is held every second Sunday of October. We'd like to thank the parish priest, Reverend Father Abraham San Pedro Pantig, as well as the Diocese of Balanga, the Minor Basilica and Shrine Parish of Our Lady of the Rosary of Orani. Thank you as well to the Parish Pastoral Council, the Mother Butler Guild, the Compañía del Virgen Milagrosa de Orani, the Hijos del Virgen Milagrosa de Orani, Most Reverend Roberto C. Santos, as well as the devotees of Virgen Milagrosa de Orani.
Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
Viva Virgen!
Thank you as well to Soko Orani, Jer Bautista and Co., as well as Team Procession. This image has been participating in the GMP since 1986. The parish was established in 1714 by Dominican friars, and the Virgin was canonically crowned on April 18, 1959. The celebration of the crowning of the image is a rare one in the Catholic Church, and the Holy See concedes the right only in very exceptional cases. In the case of this Virgin, it was the first in the history of the Philippines that such right has been conceded. Again, maraming salamat po kay Reverend Father Abraham San Pedro Pantig, as well as Diocese of Balanga, Minor Basilica and Shrine Parish of Our Lady of the Rosary Orani. Virgen Milagrosa del Rosario del Pueblo de Orani, ¡Viva la Virgen! As early as the late 16th century, the stand of the Philippine Catholic Church was to accept the doctrine of the Immaculate Conception as the article of faith, even when it is still practical to question St. Anne's conception of Mary. In fact, this was the primary factor in the endorsement of Pope Gregory XIII to build the Manila Cathedral consecrated to the conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary in 1578. After Pope representative of peace na mahalagang bilhin ng pinatawa from Marinduque. The AFD contingent for the Grand Marine Procession 2022. It is composed of the Philippine Army, Philippine Navy, Philippine Air Force, the NEG NCR, JITG, CEI, SSAFP, JCMOTG, HSSG, JTF NCR, the JTF NCR Command Group, and the JTG SEV. Nuestra Señora de Biglang Awa, Our Lady of Prompt Succor, Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
The angels is from the Diocese and Shrine of the Mahal na Virgen of Biglang Awa in Mataas na Bayan, Buwak, Marinduque. When this image was venerated in the old church of Santa Mary in Intramuros, the faithful came to invoke her help and protection. Our Lady answered her prayers promptly, thus earning her title. Community Band at sa mga taga-Buwak Marinduque, maraming salamat po. Then I'm going to go to the center of 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 people learn to help and give assistance to the less fortunate Cabalans as they give lamang or relief goods. The Cruzada was placed under the patronage of the Virgen de los Remedios because the province was in need to be remedied. In the year 1954, on the 23rd of November, the Cruzada de la Caridad y Buena Voluntad was renamed to Cruzada de Caridad y Penitencia, and the image of Santo Cristo was introduced, and this is to remind us that the Blessed Virgin, her Blessed Mother, leads us to her Son, Jesus Christ. On September 8, 1956, with the blessing of Holy Father Pope Pius XII, the Virgen de los Remedios was canonically crowned, and this was presided by the Papal Nuncio, Archbishop Alfonsi. The canonically crowned image of Virgen de los Remedios is enshrined in her repository chapel in the Arzobispo de Pampanga, and her image is brought out once for the celebration of her coronation anniversary. The image of the Virgen de los Remedios, Ituning Kapaldanan, Tulaning Kapampangan, is under the custody of the Cofradía ni Indong Virgen de los Remedios for the Archdiocese of San Fernando, headed by Archbishop of Pampanga, Most Reverend Florentino G. Lavarillas. Our Lady of Remedies was the central character in the turbulent post-war events in Pampanga. Many Kapampangans were feeling towards communism. The San Fernando Chancery is home to the image, which is brought out once a year on her coronation anniversary. Maraming salamat sa mga deboto at mga parishioners mula Guangua, Pampanga. Title is celebrated every September 8th. The image was canonically crowned on September 8, 1956 under the pontificate of His Holiness Pope Pius XII. The image before us is the official pilgrim image. We'd like to acknowledge and thank the caretaker of the image, the Cofradía ni Indong Virgen de los Remedios, as well as Mr. George Cebu. Thank you. compliments to the Banda Maniksi Uno of Bacoor City, Cavite, led by Captain Louie Ayan Ugalde.
Thank you.
Ethiopia, the Fiat Foundation, supporting the Intramuros for the Grand Mayan Procession.
Antipolo City, Rizal. Materials to employ to produce these Marian images vary. Paint on paper on canvas, polychrome wood or stone, as well as ivory. Ivory is revered as the most precious medium, valued for its rarity and its ability to be carved finely up to the smallest of details. For wood, batikuli is the most favored for its light density and its best resisting properties. After carving, the wood is then polychromed in a process called encarnacion, giving it a lifelike appearance. This process may also apply to other media of sculpture. Religious images are crafted to inspire prayer and will. The procession now ends in front of the Maria Cathedral Basilica, although the Mass is held 2 hours before the procession. The Grand Mayan Procession is not only a celebration of how communities celebrate their fiestas. We are treated to an array of costumes, music, dances, rituals and chants, and in some instances, even cuisine. They are expressions of a people's identity, glory of God. The Grand Mayan Procession is organized by the Cofradía de la Inmaculada de Concepción, Incorporated, whose officers are as follows. His Eminence Luis Antonio G. Cardinal Tagle as Honorary Chairperson, Danilo L. Dolor as Chairperson, Aurora E. Esmendi as Vice Chairperson, Lourdes T. Castañeda as President, Maria Victoria T. Burgos as Treasurer, Fe S. Rodriguez as Assistant Treasurer, Zarina O. Campos, Vicky T. Burgos as Vice Chairperson, Clifford Chuma, Armando Arionday, and Danilo Dolor. The membership committee is composed of Julio T. Castañeda and Helen Bond. The first polynomial committee is composed of Rosita Lesaca as chairperson, Nenuha Blardoni, Ophelia Recto, and Clifford Chua.
Thank you. Batangas y bien viaje. ¡Viva la Virgen!
¡Viva!
International Shrine of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage. Acknowledgements to Director Reverend Father Reynaldo Tolentino. The image was canonically crowned in 1926 under the pontificate of Pius XI, and her feast day is celebrated every first Tuesday of May. Nuestra Señora de la Paz y Bien Viaje. ¡Viva la Virgen!
¡Viva!
¡Viva la Virgen! ¡Viva la Virgen!
Again, we are deeply honored to be graced by the original 17th century image of Bien Viaje. Maraming salamat po.
Viva la Virgen!
Thank you again to Reverend Father Renante Tolentino, Director of the International Shrine of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage.
Viva!
Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
Grand Marian Procession is not only a celebration of Marian art and culture, it is also a celebration of Filipino culture. We recommend the whole efforts of our participants to prepare for days and times in the early 90s. Under the scorching sun, they get a glimpse of how we celebrate their destiny. We are treated on a variety of costumes, music. The image before us is a replica of the image in Naga Camarines Sur. This image of Our Lady is under the care of the Castello family, and we would like to acknowledge Attorney Ed Castello, who serves as camarero of the image. Local artisans carved the original image of the Our Lady of Benefrancia in 1710 based on a picture of the Virgin owned by a Spanish priest assigned in Naga. It is said that a dog was killed and its blood used to color the wood of the statue. When the statue was finished, the dog returned to its master. Once again, thank you. Kenya Francia Devotees Association, Manila. The image of Our Lady was canonically crowned on May 13, 1920 under the pontificate of Pope Benedict XV. We also would like to acknowledge Mr. Crispin Pell. Art and devotion. It is also a celebration of Filipino culture.
Dora del Santísimo Rosario de Lenoval de Manila. Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
This image is a replica of the original from Quezon City, from Santo Domingo in Quezon City. The image is taken care of by the Familia Cubo Service Camarera. The family is from Quezon City. We'd like to acknowledge the participation of Republika Filipina Reenactment Group. Maraming salamat. The Republika Filipina is represented by Alexander Avila and Joshua Matito. The image represents the tiered costumes from the 17th century. The story of the Virgin revolves around the sea vessels Encarnacion and Rosario in 1646. The sailors believed so much in their spiritual powers that they would kneel and recite the rosary while waiting for the enemy to come within range. The Spanish victories over the Dutch in the sea battles were attributed to the World War II destroying the church. The original image is currently enshrined at the Santo Domingo Church in Quezon City. Acknowledgements again to this Pasifina Ku of the Familia Ku, who serves as the camarera of the image. The family is from Quezon City.
Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
Acknowledgements again to the Philippine Red Cross for their assistance to the Grand Marian Procession 2022. Maraming salamat. Salamat, Philippine National Red Cross.
For Our Lady of the Port, this image is venerated at San Agustin Church in Intramuros, the oldest church in the Philippines. The story goes that when Saint Monica was praying for the conversion of her son, Saint Augustine, the Blessed Virgin appeared and gave her a belt or cord to wear as a symbol of heavenly consolation. The presence of devotees of the Archdiocesan Shrine of Our Lady of Consolation and Sanctuary and Parish of Immaculate Conception, Order of Saint Augustine. We also thank Reverend Father Edwin E. Hari, USA, Rector, and Reverend Father Reynante Balilo, USA, Parish Priest. Holy Rosary Youth Band 2014 from Rosario, Cavite. Once again, thank you, parishioners and devotees from the Archdiocesan Shrine of Our Lady of Consolation and Sanctuary and Parish of Immaculate Conception, the Order of Saint Augustine. Intramuros, Manila. Nuestra Señora de la Consolación y Correa. Once again. again, we acknowledge Rector Reverend Father Edwin E. Hari, OSA, and Parish Priest Reverend Father Reynante Balino, OSA. As well as Reverend Father Ricky William. Father Villar is the Museum Director of the San Agustin Museum.
The parishioners from Intramuros, Manila. Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
Concepcion, Mater Purissima, Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
Viva la Virgen!
Viva!
The image is from Intramuros, Manila. And it's from the Intramuros administration. The image is joined by members of the Republika Filipina Grand Admet Guild, headed by Mr. Alex Avila and Joshua Matipo. We also have the employees of the Intramuros administration, headed by its officer in charge, Mr. Edgardo Baisik. We also have Father J. Lina, the chairperson of the Comité de Festejos. Bishop Dennis Villarrojo of the Diocese of Malolos. We would like to acknowledge the chairperson of the Intramuros administration, the Secretary of Tourism, Cristina Frasco, as well as the members of the Board of Administrators and the officer in charge of the Intramuros administration, Mr. Edgardo Baisik. Also with us are the Hermano and Hermana Mayor, Maria Victoria T. Burgos and Mr. Danilo L. Dolor. Acknowledgements to the employees of the Intramuros administration, as well as to the Working Committee for the Grand Marian Procession 2022. Acknowledgements as well to the Chairperson of the Grand Marian Procession Working Committee, Ms. Sandra Martinez, and Vice Chairperson, Mr. Jeffrey Yap.
la Inmaculada!
Viva!
Viva la Inmaculada!
Viva!
Viva la Inmaculada!
Viva!
Thank you to the Philippine Army Band for accompanying the image of Inmaculada Concepcion Mater Purisima from the Intramuros Administration Museum Collection. Thank you to the Armed Forces of the Philippines for always being supportive and being our partners in holding the Grand Marian Procession every year together with the Cofradía de la Inmaculada Concepción Incorporated and the Intramuros Administration. The Festejada will be back, so if you would want to wait, the Festejada will be back for closing prayer and final blessing. Thank you very much to everyone who came after 2 years of the pandemic.